get Ed in, shall we? Hi, Ed.
Hello.
Right. Really, hang on. Let me turn the game volume down a little bit so that Ed is more audible, because, to be honest, you're going to want to hear what Ed is saying more than you are what the game is doing, because you've heard the game before. So, first off, let me introduce Ed. Ed is Ed Fisk from MeshTools. So, say hello, Ed.
Hello. I'm it.
So, just remind everybody who's watching what trains you're responsible for.
Oh, I'm Edward. I am the sound artist and scripter at MeshTools. I've worked on Ginty, J50, Austerities, Battery Loco, what else? Oh, the G2 working at the minute, and Stanley Tank, sort of thing.
So, there's a couple.
Yep, fair number.
So I've just turned the Skype volume down a little bit because it was clipping you a bit. Hopefully that's a bit better. But at least it means that everyone can hear you, which is better than the game drowning you out. Right, so I'm going to fire up a scenario and I'm going to switch the screen over. So let me change the title. We've got to turn off the TPTS instructions. We don't need those. This is Cole to Penrith with a Peppercorn K1. Multiplayer with MeshTools. Right. So, what I need to do now is, there's another window I can pop up, which is that one. So what you're seeing on the bottom right corner is what Ed has got on his screen. So that Ed is sharing that over Skype. That's not on my computer, that's on his. Where are you, Ed? Are you in my garage?
No, I'm about 100 miles away.
You're about 100 miles away. Okay, I was just checking. Right, okay, so we're in the scenario. And as you can see, Ed's screen is just updated with stuff.
What can I do this time?
So, what's happening here is that Ed, 100 miles away, is connected to my machine using essentially the same thing that does all of this stuff and all the TPTS. And what he's doing is he's controlling all of the firing controls. So if I look down, can you open the firebox door, Ed?
Yeah. Or shut it, open it.
Oh, hang on, I'll turn the head to F3. Right, try it again. There you go. That's it, and then close it. There you go. So this is us doing the firing. So he's got access to boiler pressure, steam chest pressure, fire mass, water level, speed. He's also got the moving map. He's got any gauges he wants to bring up. He can bring up as many gauges as he wants to bring up. And the same gauges as these on his screen. So he's got full access to all the telemetry that's going on. Right. So I don't have to worry about it. I'm just going to get on and drive. You all right doing the firing, Ed?
Yeah, I'll be alright. I'll try not to try and get.
I've got no TPTS, never mind. TPTS, no track IR, sorry. So, Ed is the fireman and I'm the driver. Yes, exactly right, Conrad. Cold plop him out. Ed is Ed Fisk from MeshTools, or Dominus Edwardius, as he is on the chat. So I'm going to pay no attention to the F5 view. I mean, I can kind of see what's going on in the window on the OBS, but I'm not going to look at it. I'm just going to drive the train. Ed is replacing TPTS bot. Well, kind of, but he's only driving a subset of commands. He has his own UI, which he's using. You can see it. So you can see his mouse there on the screen, just over. In fact, I can't point to it. So if you look at my mouse, you can see his mouse over there. he's driving that separately from 100 miles away. I'm not going to shout commands. The fireman knows what he's doing. If he doesn't know what he's doing, we're in trouble.
Now this time, I'll try not to spam that signal.
Oh, right. We tested it earlier on, and I spadded the signal. Night, Jakey Trains. To be fun with the FAF. This firing system is really fun with any steam engine, to be honest. It's not really appropriate for a single person cab. Like a diesel or electric, it wouldn't really do anything because the other person's got nothing to do. But for steam, it works really, really well. Ed has also got hold of a handbrake.
Yeah,
just to troll me. He insisted on having his own handbrake. He said, "Put the plate on the fireman's side anyway. You can't not give it to me."
Just me trying to.
The explicit. The thanks for the follow. Much appreciated. Say that again, Ed.
It was breaking case. You approached that signal a bit too quickly again.
See you later, Deadly Dorito. Right, signal's green.
Stop. Yeah.
How about the water scoop? He doesn't have a water scoop access, but there's no reason why he couldn't. I just hadn't put it in.
It'd be really hard to do with the delay.
There's no water scoop on this route, so it'd be kind of useless. Now it's a simple job of getting to Penrith. You'll be going through Barnard Castle, and there's some pretty steep grades on the way, so manage the boiler well. That'd be your job then, Ed.
Hey, so. You're looking a bit hard on me.
We'll be out of this 15 limit in a minute. If we stall, we know who to blame. Absolutely. And I've already told it. I fully plan on doing so. Loudly and vocally.
What, you plan stalling? This isn't fair. This will harm my reputation.
Oh, has one of the mods switched us back to Train Sim 2016 rather from from TPTS? If not, could one do that, please?
That's an idea.
Yukio Yamoto, I do Twitch Space Train Sim every Thursday. Stephen Cham, I can go outside the cab, it won't have any impact at all. How many cars we put in? Lots, by the looks of it. We've got all of them.
Got 900 tons behind us.
We're in a 45 limit at the moment. We've got a go and a distant go and we've got a 25 coming up after that, so get some speed up.
Mount one capitan, so.
For those that haven't seen it, can you just close the firebox door, Ed? And then open it again. That's just too cool, isn't it?
I have a bad feeling about this.
I'm going to turn train sim down a little bit more, because I can't hear Ed.
Can you wind it back a little bit? I think you've got too much steam there.
Right, I've cut back the throttle a bit. We've got a 25 limit coming up anyway.
I think we'll be approaching the signal which is on in a bit.
Right. The one we're just approaching, we just went through is off, so that's alright.
It's after the station.
Put a little bit of reg on, just let me know if you want me to cut it back a bit.
No, we're generating now.
Good. Does Ed pour the tea? No, he doesn't. He's doing a poor job of tea, to be honest.
But hey, I've got tea.
You've got tea and you're not sharing? Oh, we've got brakes on. How do we get brakes on? I was wondering why the thing was slowing down. Brakes. Can Ed see the game? No, Ed can only see the bit in the corner there. Plus, he's got his own copy of the Google map, so he can see exactly where we are. And he's got any gauges and so forth, but he can't actually see the game.
Well, can't actually see the game.
On the stream, so yeah, he's 15 seconds behind. Turning the game down a bit more. I know it's a bit quiet, but I want to be able to hear what Ed's saying.
Tell me when the injector starts.
Sorry?
You tell me when the injector starts.
I can hear hissing.
That's not what we want.
B. Harrison says, thank Ed for a brilliant 2F dock tank. No. It is a good... I like the top tank. Mm-hmm. It'll do. Oh, it's green. But I've got no idea what the next signal is. Next signal...
Oh my god, it's 231 PSI. Oh, that's why.
It's green. Excellent, let's go. Are you breaking my train?
Slightly.
Sorry? Slightly? what's it like driving from that perspective where you're not actually, you haven't got your F5 view? I mean, are the gauges, are you getting the information you need?
I could do with the reverse and regulator settings.
Interesting, so you can see what I'm doing, yeah. Make some notes and send me some notes after the stream.
I'm also trying to figure out where this jet starts.
That's it, you're running.
Ah, God. It's getting a bit warm then.
So that's one thing you want to know as well then. What would be good actually maybe is on things like on the gauges that you've got at the moment, if I put something that actually told you what its change, its delta is, so you can see if it suddenly starts going up.
Yeah. I think for the injectors we just need the actual controls, what the virtual control sets.
How long did it take to make the program Ed is using? It didn't take too long, because I already have so much of the infrastructure. I mean, Ed is basically using TS Connect, the thing that drives the rail driver on my system, and the gauges, and the map in the bottom left corner. It's just all the same stuff. Yukio Yamoto, this is a historic route, so unfortunately the map is of questionable use. Because the map is modern day, obviously. I take it this train, my first wagon's grey, so I'm guessing I'm unfitted.
Yeah, you're totally unfitted.
That would explain why I'm not getting very much in the way of slowing downness.
That's why I've got the handbrake.
Sorry?
That's why I've got the handbrake.
That's why you've got the handbrake, because you don't trust me in the ability to slow down. What is the unfitted speed? Is it 35 or 25?
Max speed 35, although I think we accept the scenario to be 45.
Oh yeah, I'm running late. I'm taking it easy. You know what? I'm not worried about the score. We're here to show off multiplayer and have a good time.
Yeah, you can give it a bit more. I don't got these injectors working.
Alright, next signal is on, so...
I think this is that weird signal which never actually clears. Let's have it.
Brakes are as on as they're gonna be.
Handbrake on.
You turn my handbrake on. Wagons shattered all over the side of the rails.
Handbrake off.
Thank you. Have you seen Train Simulator Racing on YouTube? I'm aware of it. My son does do it with some of his friends. I'm not going to show it on the stream because the chances of derailing. I know you can create things that don't, but it's. But I have got another idea, again, using all this mechanism, which will allow us to have something whereby I've got one map with everybody racing on it, and you take part. And use a client which will just put your handbrake off.
I took it off about a minute ago.
Okay, in that case it wasn't you. I just heard something click and the thing jolted.
And that was the slack.
There shouldn't be any delay. Never mind. Right, we are green to go. Brakes are off, we're in running.
And now we get the glorious uphill section. Switch to exhaust jet.
We're turning right. Need a guard to operate the brakes in the brake van. That's a cool idea, except that the brake van isn't a separate entity in the game. Train lover Ryan, you could race on the same map, but it would be on a Google Maps overlay. You wouldn't actually see each other. I think that's fine. It would mean we could, someone watching this, if anyone watching the stream, could see the green line sort of working their way around the map, and we could see who was winning and so forth. That's what I'm going to try and set up. It may be just really boring to watch, and we won't do it again, but we'll try these things. It's a bit like TPTS, multiplayer firing. Got to try these things. Boo, 20 limit.
Well, they're a bit short.
How's my boiler doing? 227. Alright, 45, and we're on a 1 in 64 at the moment. I'm wide open at the moment.
I can tell.
You can tell, yeah. See the boiler, all my coal flying out the chimney. Stephen Jam suggested that for the race, everyone should actually stream as well themselves. That way someone watching could sort of watch all the individual races. That'd be quite neat. Interesting proof of concept. Absolutely, Yatta. Got most of the train on the grade now. We're still accelerating, but we are... Oh, we're gaining boiler. We're not doing too bad on the boiler pressure. Anyone think we have an expert at the helm of the boiler?
Yeah, it's almost like I looked at what the value of the ideal fire mass was. But you can take a bit more than this. You can take a bit more than this.
She's wide open. I've got lights here. Oh, that one's okay. Need to check what Evanwood's starter is.
All these signals should be up until that signal.
Ed said that he heard it, Ed. You heard it, folks. Ed said all the signals are off.
Until the single line section.
By the way, it starts just after Evanwood. No!
I'm not actually following any trains.
Yep, start is good. If it hadn't been, that would have been the end of the scenario. Oh my word, look at that grade.
Yay. Steeper.
Is this that grade?
No, this is not that grade.
Oh, okay. This is not the one I stormed up and then spadded.
No. That's just before the signal is burst. What's it called?
Yeah, keep shoveling, Ed, says Soldier K.
That's no bounty.
Oh yes, I can see where it gets. It almost goes vertical there, just at the end.
Yep, that's the one there.
You sure this isn't the grade?
No.
Yeah, the grade this is the grade.
Oh, for the one looks the grade. Nice one in 27.
Because this one goes to like a 1 in 20 something, doesn't it? Right at the sharpest bit.
Yeah, that's the. There's no signal after that.
There wasn't a signal right after it. It was more towards, actually, it was a little bit further on. It was when it went single. In fact, this may be the scenario I blew up the last time.
It was. That's why.
Oh, now you're telling me! Now you're telling me!
That's why I made you run it again. time you're focusing on drive.
Right, 1 in 27. Mind you, I stormed up at about 45 miles an hour or something. I mean, I was absolutely going mental. Moggy would like to take this opportunity to complain about Ed's firing because it's far too good. Boiler's doing really well, actually. 223. Just backed off the regulator a bit.
Oh. Use up some of my water. I can turn out.
Floor it. Make that boiler suffer. Alright, the next signal is off, so we're good to keep going.
Actually do course. What's the bad thing?
Say again.
Run at 45 in this section. I'll tell you when to shut up in 5 minutes.
I've got to trust Ed. Not sure about that.
What?
How does the multiplayer thing work? So TS Connect is the tool that I use for doing all of the rail driver and so forth. And it's fundamentally networked. So rail driver and all this lot is actually running on a separate computer anyway. And I added in the ability for a remote and one of the client side ones that also operate firing controls, and with this little UI you can see in the bottom right corner of the stream. So Ed is connected to my home network from his place 100 miles away, connected as if he was essentially running the rail driver client, except it's got this firing interface. He's got the Google Maps and so forth, all the same ones that I'm using. And when he sends a command by moving one of the sliders there, it actually updates it on the game itself in real time. We got off and off.
Did you just apply that brake?
I did just apply the brake, yeah.
Very cool. Because
I've got three signals coming up. The two are really close together. Whenever I drive by the seat of my pants, they always end up being... it's like, it's off, off, on. And then you get like 10 meters notice of the on. So yeah, I'm paranoid these days. I drive utterly paranoid.
The next signal which is on is a single line section. That's only for the EMU doesn't pass yet.
I don't know the route very well. Shush. So we've got an on, looks like the home for a station. And we're good. Okay. Call me paranoid. You wouldn't be wrong. Right, wide open again.
God, God. When you pass the bridge, the gradient levels out and turn flat.
Shouldn't have slowed down, should I?
No. Really shouldn't have. I put it to 55% there.
How would the real driver have not known that the starter on that station was red? Because you only get advanced warning of the home. Hmm. So how would I have? How should I have known that I can proceed? Because I couldn't even see it. Until I'd actually entered the station area, which means in theory I have to enter the station area so that I can stop on site, which in this train is basically stopped.
That's the point.
See, that's the root of my paranoia. Okay. Apparently we're stuck.
What? Have you got the brakes on us?
Well... brakes are off.
Sure about that. Did the vacuum brakes on?
I got the sander on because she's slipping. Really? Corporal Pommel, yeah, we're slowing down on a slope with a tough grade. Why is it not moving? Move! Dang it! Get the Gronk to push. Yeah, really.
Huh?
Give me some more boiler pressure.
Is it 230?
I know, but I want more! Throw in the red logs.
Forgot those.
You forgot the red logs. What kind of a fireman are you? You're fired.
We've got the yellow logs.
You've got the yellow logs. Well, they'll do. Throw in some logs.
Yeah.
Moricom says, in real life, the distance covers the home and the starter. So safeties are going off on a regular basis. We're moving, you know, we are moving forward at 0.1.
It's a bizarre question, but has the wire guard's handbrake?
There's no handbrake. Let me check the back of the train. Eventually, you get to the back of the train. OMG. How many cars and freight wagons are there on this? Seriously, where's the end of the train? There's a handbrake on. Oh, look. All of a sudden. Right, so we had a handbrake on somewhere. I know I shouldn't have given Ed the handbrake.
The handbrake tick box is off.
Well, I'm not guaranteeing my software works.
Do you mean we climbed that gradient with the handbrake on?
It does explain, sometimes sitting in the cab, I've been noticing the thing jump around, and I've been, what's going on there? It's like the handbrake keeps jumping on and off. There we go. We're speeding up now. Say goodbye to your boiler.
Okay. My boiler's ready anyway.
Briggsy, it's because I've got Skype on, so Windows changes all of the way sound works when you've got Skype, a communication system running. That's it, you're going.
But it's flattened out in a second. It's still bright.
Say that again?
Flattened out in a second.
Yeah, my microphone will return back to normal as soon as I... I suppose I'm clipping out badly. Hang on. Try it now. What's happening now? Okay, how's my microphone now? I've just turned the volume right down. Hopefully it's not distorting so badly. Well, we're accelerating on a 175. Railroad is expecting a boiler explosion soon. I was expecting us to roll back down the hill, I'm going to be honest.
This is all part of my tactics here. Slow all the way down to Barnum Trust.
Yeah, I think when Skype is enabled, it's messed all my microphone settings up. GG Skype. Try the mic mute button. You first, Moggy. You first. Still clipping, apparently. I'll turn it down. It's at 10% volume now. Oh, that's way too low. How about now? Is that... Okay, that's about better. An occasional clip, I don't mind.
Then when you say goodbye to my boiler pressure... Yeah, you went half wrong.
Say that again.
No, you said goodbye to my boiler pressure. You weren't wrong.
Well, we're doing 17, hammering up the hill, full regulator. I am trying to bring the cutoff back as fast as I can.
Use up some of my boiler pressure. Got enough to last the barn to castle. Need to make up time and it'd be at 40 bars.
I think Dave's trying to convince me to turn the microphone volume all the way off. I'm on to your game, Dave. It wasn't wagon tyres, it was the loco brake that was on, Ben. I think. Was it, actually?
I don't think the guard's handbrake's that actually strong on these wagons.
Yeah, it's the loco handbrake that was on.
Got a faulty handbrake.
Yeah, that's interesting. I'm not sure why the handbrake, why it was receiving those commands. That's really odd. Hey, Francois, welcome. For those that are just joining, this is a multiplayer session. Ed from MeshTools is my fireman. I'm driving. He's firing. GG, boiler pressure.
That's fine. You don't need to wind it back.
Going downhill now anyway, so... Yeah, we will be in a moment.
Let's get to 45 miles an hour, shall we?
At 27, we are speeding up now. This time when you sign the local secretary, I'm going to leave firemen to do that. I'm down to 1 in 93 at the moment. I've got the power set to a barely minimum, so you're going to get air over the fire.
Yeah. Found some sponge, steam chest.
So what does everyone think of this? Is this something you want to see more of? Miles to Barnard Castle avoiding. You wonder if this is a hint as to what's to come in the new sim. This is no hint at all, I'm afraid, Moricom. I'm not allowed to give hints. This is simply something I developed in my own time.
Yep, that's me, S.V.E.S.
That's a boggy.
Should be clearing a single line section.
Well, let's see what the we've got. We're a little way from the. We are running late, so having a handbrake on will do that sort of thing.
Yeah, that will happen.
Francois, yes, it is Dominus Abordius that's on the stream.
When we spot the distancing, we have to put the brake on fully. Otherwise, you will not stop.
Yeah, I've noticed. I'm doing around 38, as you can tell.
Yeah, 38.11.
Okay, got another uphill section coming up here. How am I doing on a boiler? Francois, at the moment, the person who's driving needs to be the person streaming. So firing is the only thing that can be done remotely. So if it was me firing and Ed driving, essentially all you'd see is the bit in the bottom right corner. Although I guess we could stream the game back, but that would look rubbish quality-wise. I think.
Distance
is off.
But we've got 15 speed limit over the points, so we need to slow down. slow down promptly.
15, where's the 15 speed limit?
Should be over the points.
I've got no speed limit showing up.
Yeah.
Sure it was. Oh, there it is. Actually, it's just under a mile away.
Yep, this one will take a while to stop.
We need an eggs and bacon button, I think, somehow.
Well, if we have it with the air, can you? Fantastic.
So really, I guess what you want is a full set of gauges, like what's the brake doing, what's the lever doing, what's the regulator doing.
Yeah, that'll be helpful.
Almost need to mock up a cab, don't I?
Basically.
So this is cool. This is a train sim first. We have two people in the cab. TS cooperative mode.
No tanks.
Which I should highlight is not an official thing, even remotely. This will unlikely to be appearing in the game anytime soon. Stephen Jam suggests take a picture of the cab, put a green or red dot on the lever, red meaning off, green meaning on. Possibly. Possibly. Trying to avoid doing anything graphical because I'm rubbish at graphical stuff. Our next signal, the distance for the next signal was on, so it was off, sorry, so we're good.
Yeah, running late, that's why.
Yeah.
Gonna get that minus 5 points to that.
Gonna get like a minus a million points at the next waypoint. Slowing down for the signal box.
Ooh, that fateful signal.
You just bang the handbrake.
I think some of it is just the wagon slamming into the back of your open.
Oh, it could be. Yeah, my excellent driving. So many K1 scenarios. The main reason this is a K1 scenario is because it already had the... there's a particular function or capability that I need for this to work, and that's to provide access to the fire mass information for the remote viewer, which is not available the way that this needs to work on almost any Steam logo. Zartrack 844, thank you for the follow. Much appreciated. Whereas all the Victory Works ones, or a lot of the recent ones, have got that information in a place that I can use it, so the K1 was a really easy one to start off with. Going to see if I can convince Pete Gillam to come on and do some firing as well at some point.
Oh, enjoy it, love.
What are the figures representing in the middle right-hand side? The middle right-hand side? Do you mean on the bottom right? So the top one is boiler pressure, which is 211. Steam chest pressure, which is 0. And as I accelerate, you'll see the steam chest pressure goes up. Fire mass is at 0.54. Water level, 0.86. And speed, you can see, as Ed can see the speed, at 19. Just out of interest, Ed, are you using the map or any gauges or anything else?
I've got the map up. Not using any of the gauges. Not really necessary.
I don't think the gauges necessarily help. Although you would see what the brake is doing. Sorry?
Roughly see what the brake is doing. When you've got an air brake gauge. what's the signal like at my castle?
Right, our next signal distant we're just coming up to is off. This is the one in a third of a mile.
Do we have to stop at Barnard Castle?
No, we are going via Barnard Castle avoiding... Oh yes, and actually that's very confusing. The last instructions are go via, so we're just blasting through, I guess.
Strange.
What about this on a shunting scenario? Yeah, that's another good idea. There's lots, just like with TPTS, I mean, we try lots of different things with TPTS. I imagine that... for as long as I can find willing suckers, I mean volunteers, then they'll be, we'll keep trying different things.
Really do hope that's going to stop at this
point. Is this the one where you go through and you have to stop and then pull forward, or you, something funky happens at the end of the scenario, or is that a different one?
No, that's the fog one. So the DMU breaks down and comes to you and you get three detonators.
Right, I've got the brakes on quite hard now because we've got 20 limit at the bottom of this hill. And as you can see, we ain't slowing down in a hurry.
Yeah. Still. Yes.
But we are slowing down.
Tried this in the Super D, you'd be in a realism.
Sorry?
Tried this in the Super D, you'd be in a realism.
Sorry, right, I've got a split distant, I think that's a split distant, with the main signal set to off. Maxime Vett, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. See you later, Chris. Thanks for joining.
Oh, it's gonna go on.
For those that are hanging around, we're almost at the end of this scenario. For those that are hanging around, it's Class 68 next.
Self-mutant
style. Braking a bit too hard now, so I'm releasing the brakes off. Let the speed drift up a little bit. Not that much. Wow, there's a lot of signals there. I guess we're coming up. Is that Barnard? I guess that's Barnard Castle.
Yeah, that's Barnard Castle.
The home and starter for Barnard Castle, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yep, signal's off.
15.
So many signals.
Could be worse.
We've got a white. We've got white signals. They're ours.
Is the signal again deciding?
Brakes now, we're on level ground. Open the drain since we haven't been doing anything with the cylinders for a while. The way that the cylinder drain stuff works, is that based on how much time you've not had it doing anything, i.e. with the regulators off, or is it based on stationary?
It's stationary time, it's a time which adds up when you're stationary. It's over like 20 seconds.
Okay. Couldn't see that signal because of the building in the way.
That's hard on the brakes. Almost off. It was hard on the brakes.
Brakes are almost off. 15 limit. Set. Brakes are off.
Might want to add a bit of damp that.
Hmm?
The mountain's had a bit of dampened jump speed on me, so it's jumping about all over the place.
Have our banner castle down shunt, and we our signal is off. I guess we're going to get a pop up. Well done, that's not an easy task. Minus 2,800.
Yay.
No. Nicely done. Right, there you go, folks. That was a first look at my little multiplayer experiment. I hope you've enjoyed that. And thank you very much, Ed, for being my guinea pig test subject.
No problem, Matt.
What did you think?
Oh, it's a lot of fun.
Not bad, is it? That's not bad at all. Okay, well, sometime when you've got a moment, if you can drop me any feedback you've got about what you'd like to see, and anybody else on the stream, there's stuff that you want to give me feedback on about what you saw, then do give me a shout. I'll, as with TPTS, I'll continue expanding and enhancing this, and we'll do some more stuff with it in future streams. And yes, of course, this has to be done with the US Steam logo. Obviously, it has to be done with the US Steam. Imagine the 18N Connie would be beautiful with this, wouldn't it?
Not to get Smokebox on to do that.
Yeah, get Mike on to do some. Oh, that's a really good idea. We'll get Mike Rennie on to do some firing. He'll probably be on Skype yelling at me for driving really badly.
Yeah.
He usually sends me messages afterwards highlighting where I've done it wrong. All in the best possible. You know, I get on well, really well. Mike is really.
Now he can do that to you live.
He can do it live. Like, what are you doing? Stop doing that. You're breaking my engine. Right. That was really good. All right, then. I'm going to sign off from you now, Ed. Thanks very much again for helping out with that one. Really appreciate you taking some time out of your evening. And we'll talk to Ed another time. Thanks a lot, Ed.
See ya.
Right. There you go, folks. That was Ed from MeshTools. We've got one more scenario to do. Let me turn the volume back up for me. That's better. Oh, my volume's now back up. The game can come back up. And I'm going to switch to changing.